With CS:GO numbers dropping pretty drastically in the past months, no lands in what feels like decades, and no consistent new content in the game compared to Valorant at least, a lot of players have been questioning whether or not the game is dying. So today, I'm gonna give my thoughts on it and what the heck's going on. But before we get into it, I'm gonna be giving away some stuff yet again, probably just some cases this time around, and maybe some RMR stickers as well. So all you have to do to enter is be subscribed to the channel, leave a like on this video, and comment your Steam name. And most importantly, make sure your trade link is on your profile somewhere. And I'll select a few of you guys to give some cases to. Same thing as last time, don't worry if you miss out on this one, as I'm gonna try to do this in all of my videos from here on out, so be sure to check out all the new videos to have a chance to win. And final thing before we get into it, let's talk about our sponsor today, Lootbear. Lootbear is a site where you can rent up to $1,200 in CS:GO skins for as low as $15 a month. It's a completely trustworthy, scam-proof system that will 100% refund you if somebody tries to steal your items. And it's the best way out there to try out 6 skins without breaking your bank. Like, I've rented gloves, sapphire gut knives, sick rambits, really anything you can think of, and it only costs you as low as $15 a month. And the best part about it is that you can try it out 100% completely free for 2 weeks if you click that link at the top of the description. So be sure to check out Lootbear today. But for now, let's get right into the video. So first of all, let's start with CS:GO's player count and how it's been looking in the past year. Let's start all the way back at 2019, actually, before COVID was first starting. Operation Shattered Web was released on November 19th, and throughout the span of it, CS:GO had some pretty solid increases in numbers pretty much every month until we reached March 2020 when COVID started and we saw everybody was stuck at home thinking, hey, this will probably be over in a few weeks, I could stay at home and game for a while. And then it turned into a global pandemic for a year. But anyway, right off the bat, CS:GO saw a huge increase in player numbers during the first 2 months where COVID really took off and everybody was off school, off work, in a lot of cases just stuck at home. Then the 3 months after that, when summer started, even with COVID going on, the numbers pulled back a bit, as they always do during the summers. It's always a consistent trend with CS:GO. Until then, they settled down a bit. We got to December of 2020, Operation Broken Fang got released on the 3rd of December, and numbers were up for a bit. And now, as COVID restrictions are loosened up and people are just sick of staying inside playing video games, numbers are starting to die down. So player count numbers the month before COVID, February of 2019, CS:GO averaged 543,000 CS:GO players a day, and now CS:GO averages 540,000 players a day. So we're pretty much at the same spot we were before COVID started. And since Operation Broken Fang ended a month ago, I believe the 1st of June it was, this honestly isn't too bad at all for the game. It's at the same spot it was like a year and a half ago. That's not too bad considering we've been through COVID and there hasn't been like too many crazy updates besides just two operations. But I mean, the last one ended a month ago and Shattered Web ended a while ago. So CS:GO isn't looking as bad as it seems, although the player count has dropped a considerable amount in just the past few months. But the thing about CS:GO is that there really isn't any new content that often to get players to consistently play the game. Sure, you have Ancient added to the map pool, but is that really gonna bring players back to the game and playing consistently again? If we look at a game like Valorant, which is undeniably CS:GO's number one competitor, they add new seasons, new battle passes, one after another to keep players in the game and interested. Keep them playing competitive, actually giving them a reason to grind for their rank, because let's say you reach a top rank like, what is it called, Radiant in that game, or Immortal, or whatever you reach, you get rewarded the next season, like you get a cool keychain on your gun or whatever. Well, if you reach global or any rank really in CS:GO, you get absolutely nothing besides no reason to really play matchmaking anymore and just move on to Faceit or something, or just stop playing the game entirely. And then sure, you can go play Faceit or something, but there's no real reward to that either unless you're just trying to go pro, which 99.9% of people aren't gonna do. And even if you get a high rank in MM, that's not even talking about the horrible ranking system that has players with 5-year service medals, 10-year service medals, 5,000 hours, trapped in one of the lowest ranks in the game, and a ranking system that literally just has players guessing as to when or if they're even going to rank up at all, compared to a game like Valorant, which shows you when you're going to rank up and de-rank and how much you're losing and gaining per game. It's very easy to see when you're going to rank up or de-rank if you're playing a game like that, and it keeps a player grinding, I feel like. You actually know what's going to happen when you win or lose a game. So with all that said, do I think CSGO is dying and Valorant is just going to become the new CSGO or something? Well, no. The argument that CSGO is dying has been going on since the day I started playing the game over 5 years ago, and it always will as CSGO numbers keep fluctuating. But I do think Valve really need to step their game up and give players a consistent reason to keep playing the game. The way they've been doing operations with more of a battle pass style, I guess you could say, like you have to grind missions to get stars, and then with those stars you could go to a shop and buy items like we just saw with Broken Fang, I think that's a great concept and will keep players coming because CSGO items are obviously worth real money as well, and if you grind out the stars, you can literally make money. So that's a great way to get players coming back to the game, but I do think competitive still needs an upgrade. With both a ranking system that doesn't keep players guessing whether they're just never going to rank up or not, and maybe seasons with rewards at the end that keep the players wanting to play, but still, once again, compared to Valorant, CSGO is just really slacking in just everything, really. So overall, the main things I would like to see focused on are 1, more content in the game that actually make the game interesting and give people a reason to play. I literally don't even play CS anymore because there isn't a reason to unless I'm getting background footage for these videos. Unless you're grinding the game to get better, there's no reason for people to keep coming back unless there's something like an operation going on. Number 2, I would like to see fixed competitive matchmaking that actually rewards players and shows players how close they are to ranking up instead of having them keep guessing. And number 3, maybe something like a battle pass type thing consistently. Even though we obviously have operations which seem to follow this format now, the period between them doesn't seem to offer too much content. Like, even if the operations last 6 months and they're once a year now, that's still probably at least 5 months without content that's keeping players coming back. Besides one for the major and the content that that brings to the game, because I'd argue the major is something that definitely brings players back, just like an operation does. And especially with it being on land this year, finally, I think it's definitely going to bring some players back as well. But that still leaves at least like 5 months out of the year where CSGO players don't really have anything to do. So with all that out of the way, that's pretty much all my thoughts about the situation. I would love to know what you guys think about CSGO currently, if the devs need to step it up, if it's good where it's at, what should be worked on overall, and of course, once again, comment your Steam username as well and be subscribed if you want a chance at winning some free cases. But for now, that pretty much wraps up everything, so thank you guys so much for watching. Feel free to check out some of my other content if you want to learn more about CS, specifically the CSGO skin scene. But for now, I'll see you guys next one. Peace.